after this slide, the last one. Okay, so this is a slide which will help us to recognize a particular transaction as a cash transaction or a credit transaction. It's very, very important. लोग लाइटली ले लेते हैं, कैजुअल हो जाते हैं, ये तो इजी है, तो आता है, बट नहीं. Whenever a transaction is there in front of you, so you need to understand that if the word cash is there in the transaction, goods purchased for cash, it's a cash transaction. If the word paid is there, paid salary, it's a cash transaction. If the word received is there, received interest, received dividend, it's a cash transaction. So these are the words which indicate that whether the cash comes in or goes out. So by default, we are going to assume it as a cash transaction. But the last one, the very important one, which says that ki no hint at all. No hint matlab, ye koi hint nahi hai, aur yahan se bhi ye bhi koi hint nahi hai. All the five hints are not there. Then how to decide? So if there is no hint, we just assume that it's a cash transaction. Example, purchased goods, that's all. Sold goods, purchased furniture, full stop, itna hi hai. Purchased furniture 50,000. To kahan pata chalega ki cash hai ki credit hai? Because there is no hint, we'll have to assume it as to be a cash transaction. Ye yaad rakhna hoga, theek hai? And then we come to the credit transaction. Credit transaction के लिए the word credit has to be there. Goods purchased on credit. On credit, ये word है. That's a credit transaction. Another is the name is given, but you have to understand that name has to be without any hint for cash transaction. Cash transaction का hint नहीं होना चाहिए. No word like cash, paid, received, ये सारे words नहीं होने चाहिए. And name is given, then it can be treated as a credit transaction. For example, purchase goods from Mohan. Purchased goods from Mohan. Name is there, ठीक है. Word cash नहीं है, paid नहीं है, received नहीं है, तो ठीक है, ये credit हुआ. But if I just add one word over here, purchase goods from Mohan for cash. Mohan भी है, cash भी है. तो importance किसको मिलेगा? Now because the word cash is there, तो it's a cash transaction. फिर मोहन को भूल जाना है. Okay. Now this question actually question 1 and 2 that I'm going to solve with you people right now. Okay. तो ये थोड़ा सा अलग है. This will basically help us in the journalizing basically, but I want you to do it over here because this is a base for accounting equation, right? Accounting equation will start from sum number 3 basically. यहाँ से start करेंगे, हाँ, ठीक है. यहाँ से we will be having the proper format of accounting equation and all. But before I just move to the accounting equation, I want you to help me out with these basic concepts, okay? Because these concepts are definitely going to help us to write an accounting equation also, right? So let us start with, I'll give you the answer for the first transaction. After that, I expect you people to answer, right? I want to know from these transactions whether the given transaction is a cash transaction or a credit transaction. That's the first thing. For that, the hints have already been discussed. Second, which are the accounts getting affected in a particular transaction? Accounts getting affected. Now, that particular account is which type of account? Personal, real, nominal. Think over it. And then we need to give the effect on the account, whether that is a receiver or a giver, comes in or goes out, something like that. And then we decide about the debit and the credit. Okay, so let us start with the first one. First transaction says that Ram commenced business with cash. Because the word cash is there, already underlined bhi kar rakha hai maine, so cash word indicates a cash transaction. So let me write it as a cash transaction. Now, which are the accounts getting affected in this particular transaction? Ram has commenced business with cash. Because cash transaction hai, ya to cash comes in ya to cash goes out, to hoga hi hoga. So one is cash account getting affected over here.
Cash and capital account.
Yeah, that's very good. Let me write it over here. Achha, you already know the things, so better. Cash and capital will get affected because Ram is the owner of the business entity. So he gives the cash, so it's a capital account. Now, cash is which type of account? Type of account मतलब मैं traditional approach follow करूँगा, इसीलिए personal, real, nominal. तो cash is an asset. Because it's an asset, it will be my real account. Capital. Capital talks about the owner. Ram. Ram is a name. Name है तो फिर personal. ठीक है? Now, cash. Cash comes in or goes out. Again, we have to think from the business point of view.
Sure, cash is coming in.
Yeah, cash comes in. We are business, right? तो हमें वो पैसे मिल रहे हैं, किसने दिए? ओनर ने दिए, तो कैश कम्स इन फॉर अस. आप ओनर ओनर होके सोचोगे तो फिर तो अकाउंट्स नहीं करना, फिर आप बिजनेस करो, फिर जाओ अकाउंट्स करने. तो वी नीड टू बी वेरी सेल्फिश, हमें अपने आप को बिजनेस ही समझना है, दैट्स ऑल. अब कैश आया, कैश कम्स इन, किसने दिया? ओनर ने, तो ओनर इज अ गिवर. नाउ इफ आई जस्ट अप्लाई द रूल्स ओवर हियर, कैश कम्स इन रियल अकाउंट, डेबिट व्हाट कम्स इन, सो कैश अकाउंट विल हैव टू बी डेबिटेड. And capital, owner is a giver. Personal account, debit the receiver, credit the giver. So owner account will be credited. That is, capital account will be credited. So ये समझना जरूरी है. This will help us for 7th chapter, generalizing. And also in accounting equation also, पता चलना चाहिए कि कौन से accounts affected हो रहे हैं. तो वो ज़्यादा important है. कि cash है, कि credit है, वो पता करो. ये part जो है, accounting equation में बहुत ज़्यादा help करेगा. Purchase goods for cash.
Cash
transaction. Okay. Which are the two accounts getting affected over here? Purchase goods for cash.
Purchase account and cash account.
That's very good. Purchase and cash. Purchase is which type of account? Personal, real, nominal?
I think both are real.
Purchase will be nominal. Purchase is always nominal. Always. It is treated as an expense. Okay. And cash is real. There's no doubt about that. Purchase is an expense and cash. When we purchase goods, so cash goes out. So let me write over here, cash goes out, right? Now, purchase being an expense, it will always be debited. Even if you usko real mein mante ho, the goods comes in, to debit hi karoge aap. Galat nahi karoge aap kabhi bhi. Agar aap usko real account maang ke karoge to. Lekin agar maine pooch liya ki purchase is which type of account, your answer should be nominal. Agar real likha to galat ho jayega. Theek hai? Cash goes out, has to be credited. Third one, purchased furniture for cash.
Sir, it is firstly cash transaction and the two accounts that are affected. One is furniture account and other is cash account.
Yes. Okay. Furniture, personal, real, nominal.
Both are real cause, both are assets for the business.
Okay. Fine. Furniture comes in or goes out?
Furniture comes in, so it will be debited, and cash goes out, it will be credited.
Okay, that's very good. Yes, fine. Thank you, Vita. Next one is bought goods on credit.
Transaction will be credit transaction.
Okay.
Then purchase and credit accounts will be affected.
Purchase and creditor. क्रेडिट नहीं, नाम नहीं दिया ना, तो क्रेडिटर लिखेंगे. ओके, परचेज इज व्हिच टाइप ऑफ अकाउंट?
नॉमिनल.
ओके, एंड क्रेडिटर
रियल सर, रियल
पर्सन नाम होगा ना, इंसान होगा ना, कोई ना कोई तो फर्म होगी ना, तो नेम तो आएगा ही आएगा, तो पर्सनल, राइट? ओके, सो परचेज इज एन एक्सपेंस.
Expense.
Okay. And that creditor is a receiver or a giver?
Sir, receiver.
क्यों भाई, हमने goods खरीदे हैं, तो सामने वाली party goods दे रही है. So, giver.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Okay. So tell me, which account will you debit? Purchase account, debit or credit?
Sir, purchase will be debit.
Debit. Purchase is an expense, always debit. And creditor is a giver. Giver is always credit. Okay. Next, paid rent.
It will be a cash transaction.
Okay.
Account will be cash account and rent account.
Rent account is very right. Cash is?
Cash would be real and rent would be expense. So,
nominal. That's very correct. Okay. Cash comes in or goes out?
cash goes out.
Goes out, that's correct. And rent, expense or income?
Expense.
That's very correct. Okay, so cash goes out, debit or credit?
Credit.
And expense? Debit or credit? Expenses always debit. Okay, thank you, Bacha. The last one now for this sum. Sold goods costing 8,000, bought cash 11,000.
So, firstly, it is a cash transaction.
Yes, because the word cash is there. Okay, next.
The sales account.
Yes. And?
Cash account. Okay. And capital account.
नहीं, वो accounting equation में करेंगे. वो accounting equation में करेंगे. फिलहाल हम accounting equation नहीं कर. इसलिए फिलहाल कैपिटल को टच नहीं करेंगे. ओके, सेल्स, पर्सनल, रियल, नॉमिनल.
रियल.
सेल्स, इनकम, नॉमिनल.
नॉमिनल, ओके. एंड कैश इज रियल.
ओके, सेल्स, एक्सपेंस और इनकम.
सेल्स, इट इज एन इनकम, सो इट विल बी क्रेडिटेड.
ओके.
एंड कैश इज कमिंग इन, सो इट विल बी डेबिटेड.
Comes in, so debit. Okay, that's correct. We'll come to that profit word also, right, later on. Okay, similar to this, one more sum is there. You can start with the first one.
It is a cash transaction.
Okay.
And the accounts that are getting affected are cash and capital.
Cash and capital, that's correct.
Cash comes in. Okay, it is a real account, and capital is a personal account.
Yes.
Cash comes in and capital increases.
Owner is a giver. Check it. You are right, capital increases. So, okay. Cash comes in, debit.
Debit.
And owner is
and,
a giver.
Credit.
Next, furniture purchased for cash.
So it is a cash transaction.
Okay.
And the accounts which are getting affected are cash account and furniture account.
Cash and furniture is right.
Cash is a discount. I think both are there. Yes. Cash and furniture are out.
Cash comes in or goes out?
Cash goes out.
That's very good. Next one.
Yes, sir. Sir, it will be a credit transaction.
Okay.
Then purchase and credit account. Yes. Creditor account.
Creditor. Okay. Purchase and creditor.
Creditor.
Purchase is
nominal.
Okay. And creditor?
And creditor is personal.
Okay. Purchase. Expense or income?
Expense or income?
Yes. And creditor, receiver or giver?
The receiver.
Ram ka naam diya hua hai na, so let me write Ram over here. Theek hai? अब बताओ, राम इज अ रिसीवर और अ गिवर?
सर एक मिनट पढ़ लो.
बॉट गुड्स फ्रॉम राम.
गिवर सर, गिवर.
हां,
देगा ना राम.
हां, ओके. परचेस एक्सपेंस है तो डेबिट
होगा सर.
एंड राम इज अ गिवर तो क्रेडिट. बढ़िया. ओके, नेक्स्ट. विथड्रॉ कैश एंड गुड्स फॉर पर्सनल यूज. कैश and the goods have been withdrawn for personal use. That's a cash transaction. It's very important, unusual hai thoda sa. Okay, over here, one is cash getting affected, one is goods. So I'll make it stock. Okay, ya fir, you know, like you can write it as purchase always. Goods are going out of the business, other than sales, other than purchase written. We are going to use purchase account only. Theek hai? One is cash, one is purchase, and these amounts have been withdrawn by the owner. So whenever owner withdraws, it has to be drawings account. Cash is a real account, purchase is a nominal account, drawings will be personal. पर्सनल क्योंकि ऑर्डर आ जाता है, इसीलिए कैश वी नो हैज विथड्रॉन, तो बिजनेस से पैसा जा रहा है, सो कैश गोज आउट राइट. परचेज, अब यहाँ पर क्या है कि नॉर्मली परचेज हम कब लिखते हैं, गुड्स कम्स इन राइट, बट यहाँ तो गुड्स जा रहे हैं, सो व्हेन गुड्स गोज आउट फॉर एनी अदर रीजन अपार्ट फ्रॉम सेल एंड परचेज रिटन, ओके वी आर गोइंग टू यूज परचेज अकाउंट. सो माय परचेज जो है, परचेज एक्सपेंसेस नॉर्मली लिखते हैं हम लोग, परचेज इज एन एक्सपेंस जो हम नॉर्मली लिखते हैं, ओके रिड्यूसेस. अब ये सोचो कि एक्सपेंस अगर रिड्यूस हो रहा है तो हमारा प्रॉफिट है, एंड प्रॉफिट अगर तो उसे हमें क्रेडिट करना पड़ेगा. दिस इज व्हाट इज अ चेंज एज कंपेयर टू स्टेट बोर्ड एंड सीबीएसई बोर्ड. प्लीज टेक केयर, यहाँ पर ड्रॉइंग्स है, तो ओनर इज अ रिसीवर, इसीलिए ड्रॉइंग्स है. अब बिकॉज ओनर इज अ रिसीवर, तो आई विल हैव टू डेबिट ओनर अकाउंट, ड्रॉइंग्स अकाउंट, ठीक है. कैश गोज आउट इज ऑलवेज क्रेडिट. व्हेन यू कम टू परचेस, परचेस मैंने बताया कि नॉर्मली एक्सपेंस होता है तो डेबिट करते हैं, बट बिकॉज द अमाउंट ऑफ द गुड्स विल बी डिडक्टेड फ्रॉम परचेसेस, विल हैव टू क्रेडिट परचेस राइट, क्रेडिट परचेस अकाउंट. So this is really very very important. Please take care. Next, sold goods costing 8,000 at a profit of 25%. Sold goods, cash or a credit transaction?
Cash.
Cash.
Cash transaction. So when is cash? So cash account lagi aayega, and we have sold goods. That is going to be sales, right? Cash comes in a cash is a real account, and sales is a nominal account. Cash comes in because when you sell goods, so cash always comes in, and sales is to be treated as an income. ठीक है, cash comes in, so debit, and sales is an income, so credit.
तो सर यहाँ पे profit of 25% confuse करने के लिए लिखा है?
नहीं, वो आएगा. Accounting equation करेंगे तब आएगा. Yes, over here. Paid to creditor Ram. It's a cash.
Cash transaction.
Paid word आ गया ना?
Yes, sir. Account will be cash account and Ram account.
Cash and Ram, that's very correct. Cash is a real account.
Ram account.
Personal, that's very correct. Okay.
Cash goes out.
Cash goes out because it's paid. Yes.
Ram
receives
benefit.
Receiver. Ram is a receiver. Cash goes out. Debit or credit?
Credit.
Credit. That's very correct. And Ram is a receiver, so debit. Last one for this lecture, quickly. Received interest.
Cash transaction.
It's a cash transaction. Yes. Ek to cash likhi do. Second account kaun sa aayega?
Interest account.
Interest account. That's very correct. Cash is a real account. Interest
real.
Is. Interest is.
Personal.
Nominal. Personal kaise ho sakta hai? ऐसा कोई है इंसान आपके आसपास में रहता हो कोई इंटरेस्ट नाम से, इंटरेस्ट मेन, इंटरेस्ट भाई, इंटरेस्ट अंकल, इंटरेस्ट आंटी?
बट सर इंटरेस्ट तो कोई देगा ना,
कोई देगा,
कोई इंसान ही देगा,
कोई देगा उसे मतलब नहीं है, कोई देगा उसे मतलब नहीं है. हमें पैसा मिला है, क्यों मिला है? बिकॉज ऑफ इंटरेस्ट. तो इंटरेस्ट हैज टू बी ट्रीटेड राइट. ऐसे तो बिजनेस में हम हर डील करेंगे तो उसमें कोई ना कोई तो इंसान या फर्म तो इन्वॉल्व होगा, फिर सारे के सारे मतलब वही लेंगे. सैलरी हम पे करते हैं एम्प्लॉइज को, तो एम्प्लॉइज भी तो लोग ही है, किसी का तो नाम तो होगा ही. सैलरी थोड़ी ना पर्सनल अकाउंट है, ठीक है. सो कैश इज अ रियल, कैश कम्स इन एंड इंटरेस्ट
इंक्रीजेस.
Interest is an income, it increases, so it's an income, right? Interest is an income. Okay, so cash comes in always debit, income always credit. Okay, so we are done with these two sums. These two sums will definitely help you to solve the journal entries basically.